Hi everybody, thanks for watching. I recently visited my local gold and silver dealer and was able to look through his silver. And in his minimal junk tray, I guess you could call it, he had quite a few U.S. government, United States Mint commemorative dollars. And in looking through the choices he had, I spotted this 2007 founding of Jamestown silver dollar, brilliant uncirculated. Now, I do really like this coin, and I knew that they had a proof, didn't know that they had minted a brilliant uncirculated, but apparently they mint them in all of their coins. And I do know that there are only 83,000 that were minted of these, so I thought I'd better pick it up. The price for this, without the certificate of authenticity and without the box, was $25. So I thought that was a fairly good deal. Any defects that you see are small scratches on the plastic capsule, not the coin itself. So the coin depicts on the obverse the three faces of diversity, which are an African woman, Captain John Smith, and an American Indian. And the detail in this coin, as I said, is very, very nice. And I'm sure some of you know. If you haven't seen this coin up close, it is really, really nice, as just about all of the U.S. Mint coins are engraved very well. If you look real close, you can see the fingernails in the woman's hands. You know, you can see the texture in the coat that John Smith is wearing. You know, the detail in their eyes and in John Smith's beard and his hair and the folds in the do-rag, the headscarf that the African woman is wearing, and even in the beads on the necklace of the Native American Indian. And just look at the muscles on his chest and on his bicep. You know, very nicely done. The detail in his hair, the feathers, and if you even look at the detail in the straw, what appears to be straw, the roof of the house behind them. And behind them is a fence, and also in the background some ship's mast. This is a really nice looking coin. I really did like it when I first saw it, and I've always wanted it and decided to pick it up right away when I gave it a quick visual check there at the dealer. Now, on the back is a depiction of the three ships that brought the Jamestown founders, and they are the Susan Constant, the Godspeed, and the ship Discovery. And I really do like the detail in the ships also. And what I like about the reverse of the coin is I was looking at this the night that I bought it, once I got it home, and the detail in the water is extremely well done. The ship's detail is very nice, but I was really impressed with the water. And I really did like the way that they, you know, they have it here to give it some depth and dimension. Here in the foreground, on this ship in the foreground, as you can see, the detail in the water is very nice and sharp. Even leading up to the second ship on the right and the center ship in the middle. But as you get behind those ships, you see how the detail starts to fade off, and it looks, it almost gives the appearance that it's out of focus, which adds a little bit of dimension to the whole perspective of the three ships sailing in. Very nicely done. I think this was a good buy for me. I'm really happy with it. I don't know if you can find just the cases that these coins will go in. If I can find one, then I'll purchase it and put that in the case. If not, I'll just keep it like this is. I do eventually hope to get the proof, but I've always just not been able to afford it, and I just couldn't pass the BU up. Now, when I was at the that shot the same day and looking through his silver junk tray, I found a 1968 Mexican Libertad. Yes, it is a Mexican Libertad. Libertad Independencia. And this is a 1968 Olympic coin that the Mexico minted. And the detail on this is very nice. It's rough. They charged me $11 for this. This is not even 90%. I think it's a little bit less than 80% actually. So I thought I'd pick this up. You can see the Olympic rings there on the bottom of the coin. It's depicting an Aztec athlete, I guess that would be. Very nice detail for a coin that looks like it's been, wasn't very well taken care of, but the detailing is still very good. And then on the back, it has the typical Libertad with a little bit difference of a design on the snake. Here the snake, instead of on most of the Libertads, it appears that the snake is still alive and viable and maybe making its last attempt to fight the eagle. And in this one, it pretty much looks like the snake is done in. He seems to is just about ready to give up. This one here, as opposed to $1, I guess, or I don't know what I forget now what the Libertads, the value of them are. This one is 25 pesos, and I really like the way that they formed the word pesos there to fit into the shape of the coin. I like the way that they designed it, the 2 and the 5. And even the cactus and the perch that the eagle is standing on is a little bit different than the typical Libertads. And there it is, le 0.20. I'm sure that's a silver content, I'm not sure. But once again, look at the detail in this eagle. Now I will go ahead and admit that I did clean the coin up. I do clean most of the coins up that I find in my local coin dealer's junk tray, because once I look through them, my fingers are grimy. I mean, they're filthy. So a lot of that stuff, I understand what a lot of people say about, you know, you really shouldn't clean the coins. Some of that, guys, is not age. Some of that is just pure filth, just from people handling it constantly. You know, you can get home and you can run a piece of white cloth or even a tissue over it, and you're going to get grime that's going to come right off of it. That a lot of that, guys, is not oxidation. It's just grime. So, and typically what I did with this one, I liked it so much that I didn't do the typical aluminum baking soda salt. I just did the aluminum in hot water. First I boiled it, and then I put some soap in it and boiled it with soap, and then I used the aluminum at the bottom of the pan, and then I sprinkled some baking soda around the coin, not on the coin. But as like I said, as you can tell, it wasn't very well taken care of anyway, so I didn't think that I was going to do any numismatic damage to it. If it was in pristine condition, I would not have cleaned it. But anyway, this is a good-looking coin. So these are two of the buys that I was able to pick up from my local gold and silver dealer. And I appreciate you guys watching.